So there's high-level principles that we have for sort of any sort of AI deployment. We've been super public about this, right? We've got sort of AI principles that talk about how we want to responsibly launch our products, the type of guidelines we apply, the red teaming to check for abuse and what have you. But then it's going to go back to that job that I discussed, that product counsel, the person that's sitting with the team at the outset to help them navigate building that product and getting it forward. And it's their job to kind of track the laws and the rules to understand, basically as a partner to the underlying product team.
Okay, so that sounds like your job is really hard.
But fun!
for copyright.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's take a break from the minutia of that part and just talk about the broad sense. Like, it feels like the debate on the one hand is, are we crazy? AI is going to wreck everything and it is really dangerous. What are we doing? A la Barry Diller today on CNBC.
Okay.
Versus we have to regulate everything. Or let's not do anything at all. We have to let it be free because we have to see where it goes because it could really change our entire society.
Okay, so as a pragmatic lawyer, I'm going to pick something right in the middle.
Of course.
There it is, right? I'm going to stay on brand. but I'm going to say this. So AI is too important of a technology not to regulate. Full stop. It unlocks amazing opportunity. It democratizes access. It has a just panoply of options that will change society as we know it. It's a once-in-a-generation type experience. But because of that, it is too important not to regulate AI well. So I actually think, no, you cannot have a world where sort of all things run free, but you actually have to come up with an approach that acknowledges both the potential of the technology, but also acknowledges risk-based harms that that technology can produce.
Who is responsible for making all those rules? Who should be responsible, I guess? Are the right people in that room right now?
So I think at the end of the day, globally, it's going to be sort of a dialogue amongst government, the tech companies, underlying industries that are using, relying, creating the actual technology, and frankly, civil society. It cannot just be business and government. You have to understand what constituents are worried about, how they see the potential of it, and to have that addressed in the conversation as well.